In this video, I'm going to show you how to paint the Sta'Ghul Dynasty Necron Wraith. Okay, these are the colours I'm going to be using. The base coat is Vallejo model colour, black red. I'm going to brush that on, but I'm not going to bother recording it because I think we can all brush a base coat on. The next layer will be airbrushed surface primer, pure red. Then, weirdly, we're going to go in with bone white through the airbrush. There is an alternative to that, which I normally do use, but I've run out of it, and it's called yellow lasso, and you get pretty much the same effect. And finally, the miracle drug, Vallejo Model Air Orange, because of its semi-transparent nature. So stick around. I'll show you how I do it. I'm no master. I've got a cheap, nasty airbrush. I'm rough and ready. I'm not very neat. But hey, we're going to have some death metal music on in the background, so check it out. Right, here we go. I'm going to show you how I paint the orange on my Necron army. This is going to be my first ever live demo, such as it is, of me trying to nail it. So here we go. Here's some music while you wait.
I can show you the world shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over, sideways, and under, on a magic carpet ride, a whole new.
I don't know if you can see that. Let's have a little proper look. It's just a red primer essentially over a dark red primer, leaving the darkest bits left towards the edges so the red builds up in the middle. The next stage will be to use, I know it sounds weird, but like a bleached bone type colour, and then it'll look stupid. And then the third stage, which is with the orange paint, is where the magic happens.
I can show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide? I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over, sideways, and under, on a magic carpet ride, a whole new world, a new fantastic point of view.
Okay, this is the final stage. Vallejo Orange, 71.083. This was found out completely by accident because it turns out it's semi-transparent, so it's like a glaze or a ghost tint type paint. But effectively, it's pre-shaded. Sorry to swear, but you know, it's pre-shading with the primary colours that you're using. So I'm going to show you what happens when you stick the orange over this now, and hopefully it'll work out. If not, I'll look like a dick.
I can show you the world, shining, shimmering, splendid. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart decide?
Wallop. So that's come out, that's most of it done. Once that's dry, what I'll do is I go in with null oil through the airbrush, which just exaggerates or helps the transition from the orange to the dark red or the black. So effectively a lot of the red's disappeared, but without it the orange wouldn't go down very well. So that's it. This is just going in with a very tiny bit of black ink effectively to really sharpen up the contrast.
A whole new world, a dazzling place I never knew, but when I'm way up here it's crystal clear that now I'm in a whole new world with you.
Now I'm in a whole new world.
Right, that's the orange done, effectively. So the next bit
I look to do is all the little circuitry bits in here. There's a lovely recessed detail, and I try and create the effect that there's power within there. And I do this using, where are we? Dawn Yellow Edge Paint. It's the brightest yellow I've got, and it's lovely. And it's quite an opaque paint as well, which is very nice. So what we try and do is paint it into all the lines there. It usually takes a couple of coats because you want it to be really solid. So I'm going to give this a little go. So you can see there, the yellow is within the energy circuitry, so it looks like it's glowing from the inside. So the next thing I'm going to do is paint Fire Dragon Bright from Games Workshop's paints on the outer edges that traces along all the detailed lines. So effectively it's like a reverse highlight. So you can see there, I finished the highlighting, or the low lighting almost, of the yellow. Obviously done the vents there. So overall, the effect, you can see it most there. That the combination of the blend, the black wash, the highlight with the orange, and the very brightness of the yellow in the circuitry combined with the orange makes it look like it's almost like lava running underneath it. So that's the finished armor.
I can show you.